Hey guys, Huzz here, bringing you another video, this time talking about the HuzzyGames stream. It's a topic that I haven't talked about in quite some time, and I thought it was about time I'd bring it up. Talk about it, get feedback, ask questions, that type of thing. So before we get into it, some of you may notice this. For those who are unaware, or you should be aware, I play for a team called Absolute Zero, and this is our hoodie that we basically got recently, and it's amazing. The jersey is... This is the jersey, for those who haven't had an in-depth look at it. Obviously, I did put pictures on the Facebook. But this is the jersey. It's pretty good quality. Make sure I don't get it in the mic. That's the front of it. And then there's the back of it. You can see there's a faint polar bear with Huzz on the back. And then there's the hoodie. That's amazing quality. There's also Huzz on the back of this. But I thought I'd just quickly say, if you're going to London LCS, I'll be probably wearing at least the jersey and probably this if it's bad weather. If it's like mild weather, I'll probably be wearing the TSM jacket. But I'll be definitely wearing this so you can kind of spot out the Absolute Zero crew, because I think all of us will be wearing them. Anyway, moving on to the actual point of the video, the stream. Right, for those who aren't aware, I used to stream quite a bit a few months ago. I haven't streamed, honestly, seriously, I'd probably say in about 4 months. And the stream is www.twitch.tv/HuzzyGames, and this video is basically going to be aiming whether you guys want me to stream again, as I actually have been, like, let's be honest, the reason that I haven't been streaming is, I could give you a list, but the main one is me being lazy. I won't hide away from that. Streaming takes a lot out of you. I respect people that do it for like 10 hours a day. When normally I stream, I do about 3 hours, but now that I've got the summer off, and if I start streaming again, I'll probably do about 5-6 hours at a time. But yeah, I thought I'd just go into a video basically saying, do you guys want me to start streaming again, is the main question. And if you did, I'm interested to see how many people would watch. So in the comments and the description, there is a straw poll of basically that. You know, will you watch the stream? And I just want to kind of get a general sense of how many people would be willing to watch. As if I did start streaming again, one of my targets would to actually get partnered with Twitch. That would be something that I would want. And saying that, I wouldn't run a single ad. The ad money and that, it doesn't interest me. The main things that interest me is, one, quality options. A lot of people, when I used to stream, was like, Huzz, I'd love to watch your stream, but there's no quality options. My internet does not, cannot watch it because it's too high quality in, you know, the HD and all that. And that always frustrated me, as I couldn't really cater to everybody, but I like trying to do it as much as possible. And if you're partnered, you get quality options all the time. I know that Twitch nowadays, if you get about over 200 odd viewers, they try to give you quality options, even if you're not partnered nowadays. But yeah, if you're partnered, you always have quality options. And secondly, you know, there is the subscriber thing that I'd like to do. I'd love you know, I give lessons to people. People recently actually have been private messaging me and booking lessons with myself. I'd like to do like a monthly thing that everybody that is subscribed on the Twitch, they go into a draw and someone gets an hour lesson straight up for free. And I'd love to do that. That would be pretty good. I'd have subscriber days, but make a little bit of a community on the Twitch. That would be something that I'd love to do. But to get partnered would need quite a bit of your help. And that is what this video is going to be about. If you guys want me to start streaming again, and I'll be going through in a second what the stream kind of contains, what I normally do anyway, I'd need from you guys about a week of 300 to 400 people watching most times I have the stream on. Basically what Twitch kind of does with partnership, I won't go into too much detail, but Twitch works it in kind of a few ways. If you have a YouTube channel or a social media, Facebook, something, over 100,000 followers or subscribers on YouTube, then you can get your partnership fairly easy. They just need to see you streaming on a regular basis with some viewer base. If you're not over 100,000 YouTube subscribers, which obviously I'm not, then they need to see about, normally the number is about 300-400 people consecutively for about a week. Then if you apply for it after that week, you're not guaranteed to get partnership, but you have a good chance. Especially if I also say, you know, I do have a YouTube channel as well. You know, that is, I have a good chance of that. So, as I said, the straw poll in the comments and the description is basically asking, would 300-400 people be willing to watch for like nearly five, six days consecutively to try and get myself partnership? That's pretty much it. That is down to the bones. And, you know, partnership isn't everything, but it would be a massive thing to me if I were to start streaming again. And then here's the thing, you know, if you're sitting there now, you've got your favorite streamers already, you know, you've got Odd One, Fi even, you know, I know he's going for his partnership as well right now. What does my stream offer? Well, one thing that I try to do, which a lot of big streams kind of forget, is, you know, the fans type thing. They are like, a lot of like Odd One, he can't answer that many questions. And I'm even subscribed to Odd One myself. But when I stream, I try to answer as many questions as possible. If that does mean I have to have chat on slow mode to kind of read them all, sometimes I have to do that, but I try to get through as many as possible. And have an idea of what the stream is like, if you've ever watched the Unranked to Gold series that I've done on the channel now, it's kind of like that, the streaming style, but with good music, or what I deem good music, and it's a personal library of mine that I've made for the past like over a year, and it has all different types of music. You know, there's Disney songs, Michael Jackson, everything, Mumford and Sons. It's a pretty cool playlist. And then adding on to the Unranked to Gold series, so there's the music that the Unranked to Gold series doesn't have, and there's also the interaction with you at home, answering questions and all that type of thing. And that's it. That's pretty much what my stream would be like. It would be pointing out mistakes, you know, my own mistakes, the enemy's mistakes, answering questions in Twitch chat, and having hopefully a good time with some good music. So that's it. So in the comments and description, let me know of how many of you would actually be willing to watch. Now that I think of it, there'll probably be three options. There'll probably be a yes, I will watch, no, not interested, or there'll be when I can. So the when I can one will basically be if there's no other good streamers on, none streamers that I want to watch, then I'd probably watch your stream, but I would still prioritize others. But that's it. So the question is there for you. Would you be willing to watch me if I were to start streaming again? So hopefully this video is okay, as it's a topic that I wanted to get pique your interest in, and also I want to kind of just have a feedback on. So anyway, hope you guys are enjoying the content on the channel. My hair's a mess today, and I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye!